A local business in the market of sauerkraut has made quite the name for themselves in the past few years, and the pandemic has not slowed their progress at all. 3 News food expert Doug Trattner talks with the owners of Cleveland Kraut on what's changed in their unique approach to food.
Hey guys, thanks for joining me today. Can you tell me who your partners are and what year you guys started Cleveland Kraut?
You bet. Thanks
Absolutely.
For having us here,
Thanks
Doug.
Thanks for having us.
So we started right at North Union Farmers Market.
Beginning in 2014.
And today we're in about 8,000 grocery stores nationwide.
I remember when you guys started the farmers market. It was you three and you had a giant bucket like that. And you had to convince people that sauerkraut was something worth trying. I mean, that's an uphill battle.
Yeah, you know old school sauerkraut that's mushy. Maybe your grandmother would cook the heck out of it and stink up the kitchen or whatever. This is fresh stuff, and it's crunchy and it's delicious, and you can think of it as just a fresh fermented vegetable or slaw, and then try it. You'll be surprised by the flavors, and it worked out.
Remember when I tried Cleveland Kraut for the first time, and I said, this is nothing like the sauerkraut that I remember.
Right. The first year and a half, we'd leave our office jobs at 7 p.m., go to the commercial kitchen till 2 in the morning, and sell on the weekends. And what kept us going was people were trying it, and they kept coming back because it was fresh, delicious. They were throwing it on eggs in the morning, avocado toast, salads, and you know, chef partners like Michael Simon were picking us up and featuring us on the menu. So, you know, we knew we kind of had something, and it kept us going through those really kind of hustle times.
Yeah. Yeah.
Correct me if I'm wrong. I remember Cleveland Kraut used to come in a glass jar. Now I see a pouch. Tell me about the packaging shift.
Yeah, absolutely. So the jars, we loved the jars. We loved the way they looked. But the problem was, and you saw this, they would bubble out, they would spill on shelves, there was a lot of breakage.
What people don't realize is this is still alive.
These actually are the right home for fermented foods. They have a nice breathable vent. So as a fermented food continues to kick off CO2 as it continues to ferment, continuing that process, these actually allow it to off-gas naturally. So this is the home for ferment. You know, it'll live very nicely here for a year in your fridge after you open it, a few months. You'll eat through it within a week, but this is a fantastic home for fermented foods.
And you mentioned it earlier, but right now, I mean, people can get your product, what, from New York to California and Florida?
Yeah, yeah. Even Alaska.
All 50 states. Yeah. Hawaii.
Hawaii.
They sell Narnar and Walmart.
You guys are doing Cleveland proud with the name, with the brand, and the product. Thanks for spending time with us and showing us around.
Thanks so much,
absolutely.
Doug.